Hello, Jeff Gadick here live at USTOA 2011 in Marco Island, Florida. With me is Terry Dale from USTOA. Terry, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good. It's nice to be down here this time of year.
It's a beautiful thing because I think, well, when I head north and you head west or to the Midwest, it's not going to be quite this temperature.
Not for many months.
No, exactly.
So, Terry, this marks officially your second conference with USTOA. You and I sat down last year, and I learned a very valuable lesson: is don't ask the new guy how many years the conference has been going on.
Yes, right. And don't ask me today either, because I mark it by, well, this is my second one. First one I observed. This one has been one to own. But I'm very happy.
Yeah, it's the pre-Terry Dale area and the post-Terry Dale area.
Exactly.
So for our audience that is not keeping track of USTOA on a daily basis or regular basis, bring everybody up to speed on what you've been working on the last year.
Sure. Well, fortunately for me, I inherited an association that really had a solid foundation. You know, 40 years, Bob Whitley, an extraordinary leader. And so, you know, we had a base. And it was really more about coming in and then analyzing the base and saying, you know, how can we help it evolve? How can we make it more relevant? And so we did that by really activating the committee structure. And the good thing for USTOA is that we have board members who are extraordinarily committed to the mission of the association and who really jumped in with the committee structure. The other thing to add is that we started for the first time an Associate Advisory Committee. And this was an opportunity then to hear from our supplier members what's important to them and how do we integrate what's important to them into our programming at USTOA. Okay. Then the next step was to identify the partners that we needed to help us take the foundation, you know, ramp it up, make it a little more relevant, a little more fresh. And so we, you know, got new PR counsel. We had an opportunity to employ a lobbying firm for the first time. We moved to new offices. We did a website audit. We did a brand audit. So we did. Now we just got to make all of the doing congeal. And for our 40th anniversary, then we'll finally, see all of this kind of come into fruition.
It's good to hear a fresh approach to everything that you're doing. It seems like you've analyzed the website infrastructure,
yes,
the organization at its core, and poised for growth moving forward.
Oh, absolutely. And again, I want to pick up on when you say poised for growth, because it reminds me of our member survey that we just released here at the conference. And what was interesting for 2011, Jeff, we were pleasantly surprised. 64% of our membership saw an increase in sales. Hmm. And even more important, 8 out of 10 saw an increase in ADR. And as we then said, well, how does 2012, from your opinion, going to shape up? 3/4 of them are cautiously optimistic or optimistic. And they believe that sales will increase again in 2012. So all of this is trending in the right direction. It doesn't mean that it's not going to be challenging at times.
Absolutely.
Because as we know, the roller coaster, you know, of Wall Street, it impacts all of us.
In my experience with tour operators is if you're not optimistic, you're probably out of business.
That's probably an accurate way of looking at it, yes.
Glass always has to be at least half full.
Right.
Terry, there was some talk earlier in the conference about the slogan Integrity in Tourism, and that has been a mainstay of USTOA for many, many years. How is that relevant today, and how do you see that maybe changing moving forward?
Well, let me just stress that integrity in tourism will always be a part of USTOA. It's just too critical. It reflects what we believe in. It reflects our members' commitment to consumers through our travelers' assistance program, so on and so forth. But we will look through our brand audit to see if there's another way of positioning, in addition to integrity in tourism,
sure,
that may relate to younger generations of travelers who may have a different definition of integrity. So it's part of that evolution process, but it'll always be a part of who and what we are.
Okay, so we're not going to see USTOA members not have integrity.
We will always have integrity.
Oh, awesome. Growth areas moving forward. Where do you see the association going? Is it new tour operator members? Is it different directions with your existing members, maybe more niche markets? What are some of the things that you guys are talking about?
Well, I think it's important to stress that USTOA will always be a select group. We don't want to become the largest. We just want to be quality and the best. And so, you know, because the beauty of this conference even is that, you know, it's small enough where you can really meet and talk with people, as opposed to some of the larger ones where, you know, you hope to see in passing someone. Well, here you really have that opportunity. So we don't want to be biggest. We just want to make sure we're the absolute best. So to answer your question, we've got several new tour operator member prospects that look very promising. We announced this year at Cox and Kings. We've got a couple more who are in various stages of the application process, a couple more next year who will meet some of the guidelines that we've established or the standards that we've established for the first time. So there's some strong, promising prospects for growth in the tour operator member. And the associate member category, it's almost limitless. But again, we don't want the supplier, the associate category to become so large that then again we don't have that ability to really build relationships.
And it has to be a good match as well. If you're bringing in prospective or associate members that don't have product for your members, they're going to come to the show, they're going to be disappointed, right. And ultimately that's not going to help the association.
Right, and then they don't retain their membership. Correct. So our goal is not to, you know, all right, 2012 we got 150 new associate members, but then in 2013 we lose 85 of those. It's really to get the right number, the right quality, so that they stick with us. And you know, as you walk through the show, you find that people, this is my, you know, 28th USTOA conference. Well, we want people that we engage with next year to be with us 28 years from now too.
Well, thank you very much for your time today. Congratulations on a very successful show, and great to see you.
Thanks, Jeff.
Thanks.